again, and welcome back to the card, Matt. Right, GTA CR 2.0, how's it done? Well, a lot of you might have already guessed I was using not just one four of diamonds, not just two four of diamonds, not just three four of diamonds, not four four of diamonds, not five four of diamonds, but yes, six four of diamonds. I didn't use that one because that's the King of Spades. Doesn't work with that. Right, yeah, so all four of diamonds, six four of diamonds to do the trick, but you do have to do something to five of them. Yeah, a lot of you have twigged already. Have a regular four of diamonds, then get a couple of other cards and peel them, so you just got the paper, cut the corner off and stick it over the top. Yeah, you can just see that, and that paper is just coming off slightly on that one. Needs a little bit more glue. But if you get it in the right light, I won't use that one because it's coming off. If you get it in the right light, it's pretty much invisible. And I mean, that's pretty close to you. Trying to keep it in. But you get it at the wrong light and you will see it. You can see, yeah. A little tip when you cut on it, don't cut through any of the colour. Try and just go through the white. See how it just dodged the two pips. Yeah, just do it like that on as many as you want to. You don't have to use a four of diamonds either. You can use whatever cards you want to. Now, in case you haven't worked out how it was done, you have your regular card on the top. Yeah, another thing. Oh, I'll tell you that when we get to it. I have these other ones on the top of that, but have the gaffed index towards you. Right? Now, you need to force that top chunk of cards, whatever way you want to, as long as you force them. What I done in the performance was, again, just took a couple of cards off the top, as long as you're taking more than your gaffs. Put it down behind, just catch a grip of it there as you shuffle off the rest of the packet. And then you can just drop them straight on the top, keeping them exactly where they were. And you can do that as many times as you like. And then when the spectator tells you to stop, all you're going to do is stop, drop, pick up them cards, put them to the bottom, and you've got all your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 cards all up on the top. What card have you stopped me on? Slide the card back and grab it in the bottom left corner and turn it over, just so you're covering over that index where you stuck that bit of paper. You've got a four of diamonds. You can then let them see that four of diamonds going into the middle of the packet. You do your little magic gesture, you'll slide the next card back and you'll turn it over in the exact same manner. Let's come back to the top. Put that in. Try and keep a bit of space between where you're putting the cards in. So you're not going to get, like, if you stick them all in the middle and they all go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 together. When you do a spread at the end, you're going to have all them diamonds together. It might look a bit suspicious. Four of diamonds back to the top. Stick it into the middle of the packet. Keep a count of how many you are doing. And if you can't do that, when you get hold of it, you will be able to feel the little lip underneath your thumb where you stuck that little bit of paper. Four of diamonds. Again, we'll stick that somewhere into the middle of the packet. Magic gesture. Slide it back. Four of diamonds. This is my last gaffed one. Put that somewhere into the middle of the packet. Magic gesture. Exact same move. This is the regular four, but hold it exactly the same way so you're covering that pip. And then you can do your little reveal to show it's the four. In case they don't trust you, grab the packet and turn it over end to end, because you've got your gaff indexes down here in this corner and you want them up there in that corner. So you just turn the packet over end to end. Then if you're using decent cards, which I'm not, you'll be able to do a nice little spread. And they won't get onto it because they're looking through to try and see the four of diamonds. Make sure you don't do something like that though, because you can look at that and you can see straight away that is not an eight of diamonds, because an eight of diamonds would have another pip in the middle there, wouldn't it? Yes, it would. Where's an eight? There. See, you'd have another pip in. The nine, you'd have another two pips in, wouldn't it? 1, 2, 3. Yeah, the nine would have another, yeah, have another two pips in on the nine. So as long as you can get it so that all they can see, obviously with a decent pack of cards, you will do it. They're looking through to try and see, a four of diamonds. They're not paying much attention down the middle of the card. They're just looking at their indexes, trying to see if they can see any fours, which they're not going to, because they'd have to do that to be able to see the four. And there you go. That's exactly how I done that one. Yeah, smashing. Thank you very much. I do hope you enjoyed it. Does mean you're ruining a couple of cards, but for an effect like that, I think it's worth it. Thank you very much. I've got to get back to doing this room. I nearly swore again. Yeah, how many times I've done this and I've come out with it. I'm shutting up. I'm getting off. I'm getting too loud. Thank you very much for watching. I do hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you again soon.